What's up, guys? I'm Shane, and this is Spare Change. If you've got a passion for new movies and for new audio and video gear, then tap the subscribe button for new weekly videos. In for a review, we've got Iron Man 3 on 4K Blu-ray. I won't be reviewing the actual movie itself, I'm just going to share with you my thoughts on the video and the audio quality. Now for a few tech specs. The movie was shot in 2.8K, it's got a 2K DI, it's rated PG-13, runtime is 130 minutes, aspect ratio is 239:1, so yes, you will get those black bars. I know, a few of you are going to ask, why start with 3? Why don't you review the first movie first? Well, I wanted to start with the best looking one first, therefore I went with part 3. First off, leave a comment if you picked up those trashy German 4K Iron Man Blu-rays. Brass tacks told me to pick them up and that was a mistake. Those were so bad I didn't even bother to review them. Anyways, if you're coming from the original 1080p Blu-rays, I think you'll find there's a nice increase in detail. It's by no means a super 4K crispy transfer, but it is noticeably tighter looking than the standard Blu-ray. The obvious close-up shots benefit from the added resolution, with facial hair and pores really coming through. The detail found on Iron Man's armor, right down to the little dings and dents, were rendered really good. Although I do think there might be a touch of sharpening going on here and some DNR in certain scenes. It reminded me of Age of Ultron, where some shots had a slightly smoothed over look. It isn't Terminator 2 Judgment Day smooth, but I feel there was a little bit being applied. As for the color palette, HDR's wider color does retain better highlight and shadow detail over the 1080p version, so things like explosions or nighttime shots will have more visible detail rather than getting blown out or getting crushed, like what was found on the German 4Ks. Now if you're expecting to be wowed by the HDR 10 colors, I think you'll find this presentation is more natural, if not somewhat dull looking. Colors don't really pop, nor will they be searing your eyeballs out. There's some decent spectral highlights from explosions and from Iron Man's glistening armor, but again, nothing really bright and bold. Shadow detail, like I mentioned, was better than the 1080p version, but it wasn't quite as deep and contrasty as, say, even Endgame. I actually found the movie to be kind of dim looking.
Everybody needs a hobby.
Audio gets a brand new Dolby Atmos mix, and I think it falls on the moderately active list of immersive soundtracks. Some notable scenes would be the first time Tony tries out his new armor in Chapter 2. In this new Atmos mix, you'll be able to hear the different parts of his suit flying from the back speakers all the way around to the front and even up above your head. The Barrel of Monkeys scene in Chapter 14 had some cool aerial Atmos height effects when the people are whipping around the room. The highlight of the movie would be the final battle in Chapter 15, with all the different suits of armor destroying everything and flying in and out of different speakers. There's explosions going off in the distance and bullets flying in every direction. So there are some good Atmos height effects, but it was nothing demo worthy. Now, unlike Endgame, which had some killer bass response, Iron Man 3 was just straight weak. And here I thought Disney was upping their audio game. Explosions lacked real weight and impact, and everything was just a light rumble. Well, it was a little more than a light rumble. It was a disappointment. Volume level, on the other hand, isn't as bad as earlier Marvel movies, but you will have to raise it just a couple dB more than normal. And dialogue was fine without any issues. So for audio, I'm gonna go with a 7.8. Atmos height effects were used sparingly, and bass response was weak. Dynamics could use some help, but overall, it followed the on-screen action perfectly fine. For video, I'm gonna go with an 8. I thought the movie had some good detail and sharpness, although I do think there is some light noise reduction being applied. Black levels were okay, not great, and HDR10 isn't going to be anything to blow you away. Now if I don't review the other two Iron Man movies, just know they get incrementally better, with Part 3 being the best looking of the bunch. So if you're wondering if you should grab this on 4K or stick with your regular 1080p versions, I think it's kind of a no-brainer. The 4K versions are better looking and definitely better sounding. So if you do want to grab these movies on 4K Blu-ray, I'll leave some links for them down below in the description. It does help out the channel by using those links, which helps us bring you more videos like this. So what are your thoughts on these new Iron Man 4K Blu-rays? Did you pick up the German versions, and how do you think they compare to the official US ones? As always, thanks for watching. You can find us on social media, and if you want to support the channel and get up-to-date info on future videos or just have questions, then stop by our Patreon page. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you guys again in the next one.